हेलो एवरीवन, आई असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर प्रगति शेट्टी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी के जे सुमैया कॉलेज. इन द लास्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर वी सॉ अप टू द लैबोरेटरी डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द इन्फ्लुएंजा वायरस, राइट. वी स्टार्टेड विद द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द इन्फ्लुएंजा वायरस. देन आफ्टर स्ट्रक्चर वी सॉ द एंटीजेनिक वायरल प्रोटीन्स. देन वी सॉ द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ द वायरस, प्रोटीन्स, एंटीजेनिक टाइप, राइट. द थ्री टाइप्स ए, बी, सी. Then we saw the epidemiology of the influenza virus. After epidemiology, we saw the pathogenicity and the pathogenesis of the virus, right? After that, we saw the clinical features or the clinical symptoms of the virus. Then we saw the laboratory diagnosis of this virus, right? How we do isolating the virus and how we will confirm the presence of this virus. Right, this is the laboratory diagnosis of this virus. After that, now in this lecture, we will see the seasonal influenza virus, it transmission, right. Influenza A, that is subtypes, is the this points has been discussed in the epidemiology of the influenza virus also, right. Now influenza A and the B, in the influenza type A, what are the subtype AH1N1 and the AH3N2, okay. And the influenza type B having the B and the B Victoria and the B Yamagata, these are the two subtypes, okay. Very common are the influenza A subtype, which are the AH1N1 and the AH3N1N2, all right. These are some sub, these are the subtypes of this virus. Now the important thing is the immunoprophylaxis and the chemoprophylaxis, that is the treatment of this virus, all right. Now in the immunoprophylaxis, we used, what is the immunoprophylaxis? Prophylaxis means the treatment, right. And the treatment related with the immunity of the person. If we take vaccines, then vaccine, right, that plays the role in our immunity, right. That means if we get the disease or if we get that pathogen again, that we have the antibodies ready with us in the defense mechanism for that pathogen, right. Therefore, it is incorporating in our immunity, and therefore the process called as the immunoprophylaxis, okay. Now in this, we have two types of vaccines, inactivated vaccines and the live attenuated vaccine. What are inactivated vaccines? These are the original vaccine, okay, consist of the viruses, okay, grown in the, as we isolate the eggs, right, alone the cavity of the eggs, and these are inactivated with the formalin, which means we have the viruses grown and which are inactivated for certain time period unless and until the pathogen will come, the influenza virus is come, it will not get activated, right. All right, these are called as the inactivated vaccines. And the subunit vaccines are also there, okay. This first inactivated vaccines had some side effects, okay. Side effects such as the fever and the local pain, and to reduce this, we have the modified subunit vaccine. And the recombinant vaccines is also used, in which the vaccine with the antigen from a new variant. The recombinant vaccine, if we take, then the various antigenic, different antigenic nature of the viruses, for that also we have the vaccines in our body, okay. Now the second one, that is the live attenuated vaccine, or can be called as the cold adapted vaccine, okay. Now this is to enable the specific immunization, local immunization live vaccines, right. These are the common, the live attenuated vaccines, right. These are the two types of vaccines, inactivated vaccines, right. We use this in the immunoprophylaxis. In the inactivated, we have the subunit vaccines, which will reduce down the toxic effects of the inactivated vaccine, the original one. And the next is the recombinant vaccine, in which there are the antibodies or there are the immunity for the various antigenic variations of the virus. Okay. And the second one is the live attenuated vaccine, can be called as the cold adapted vaccines. Then next in the chemoprophylaxis, okay, in the chemoprophylaxis, which are the drugs we can use to treat this virus. Now we can use the amantadine and the rimantadine, okay. We can use this very useful in the treatment of the influenza, all right. They mostly reduce maximally reduce the average duration of the disease, okay, and resulting into the improvement. Okay, then we can use the new drugs that are designed, which are the zanamivir and the oseltamivir. These are the newly designed drugs which will block the viral neuraminidase. Okay, see, we have saw in the earlier lecture the neuraminidase is responsible for initiating the facilitating the infection, right? It is responsible for reducing the viscosity of the mucus lining of the respiratory tract, and therefore these drugs will block the neuraminidase only. Therefore, if the virus is even enter in our body and we take this drug, then what it will do, it will block that neuraminidase so that the further infection will not only happen. All right, these are the drugs we can use to treat the influenza. Now in this online lecture we saw the immunoprofile axis. Okay, in this we saw the vaccines and the drugs that we use to treat the influenza. I hope you understood this online lecture and the whole influenza virus topic study. If you have any doubt regarding this, please ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.